South Africa has scarce water resources, yet water is vital for human health and dignity. The Department of Water and Sanitation is the national custodian of water resources, but municipalities are responsible for securing water resources, treating the water, and distributing it to users in an efficient way. This is a critically important function. The Bill of Rights says that every South African has a right to sufficient water. One of the greatest success stories of the new South Africa is the rapid expansion of water provision to almost all South Africans. But this success story is under threat. Increasingly, a number of municipalities across South Africa are struggling to deliver efficient and safe water services. Nationally, about a third of our water is lost, mainly due to leaks. This is a situation that needs to be turned around. With the right political will, such challenges in local government can be addressed. Drakenstein Municipality, run by the Democratic Alliance, a partner organization of the Friedrich Naumann Foundation for Freedom, has made great strides in reducing its water loss.
A huge amount of our economy evolves around the Berg River. And to us, that is very important because fruit exports to Europe is such a big part of our economic backbone in Drakenstein.
In the year 2000, Drakenstein Municipality recorded a water loss figure of 34.8%. Its officials set about fixing the problem.
Drakenstein Municipality uses various water demand management interventions to reduce the water losses, namely the use of rising block tariff structure, universal metering, which means the metering of all unmetered connections, pipe refurbishment and replacement, where we replacing the older space pipes with the more high quality plastic HDPE, promote public awareness of the consumers having to use less water. We also use the telemetry system to monitor critical sections of the network, and we also do pressure management.
The results have been spectacular. By 2013, the municipality had reduced its water loss to 12.1%. This is among the very best figures in the country. The steps Drakenstein took to achieve this excellent outcome can be replicated in all other municipalities in South Africa. Drakenstein Municipality is also an innovator when it comes to water treatment. Studies showed that Drakenstein could reduce its water costs if it treated more of the water located in local dams for the use of residents and businesses. They recently completed the construction of a state-of-the-art water treatment works, Mühlwasser, to increase local treatment capacity.
We use water that normally runs down to the sea that we can treat and put back into the system, much cheaper than the water that we purchase from Cape Town Municipality.
There were some stringent or strict conditions which required that the footprint of the plant had to be as small as possible to minimize the impact on the mountain and still to get the plant to be as efficient as it is at the moment.
The plant design has little environmental impact on the Palm Mountain. It also blends into the area beautifully from a visual perspective. The building sits up to 5.5 meters underground in some places, and roofs are covered in fynbos.
The best and the newest of technology available in South Africa.
The treatment plant is highly efficient. It has a direct filtration system and a unique backwash system that reduces water loss.
The municipality itself would be in a worse financial situation if it wasn't for Mühlwasser, as now we're using more of our own water, meaning that we're not buying that much water from the city of Cape Town.
That makes me as a councillor very proud, of course, and it's an amazing adventure for me to be working with such professional people like Andre and Sifiso and everybody around them.
Overstrand Municipality, located to the east of Cape Town, is another municipality run by the Democratic Alliance that takes water management seriously. A few years ago, it was faced with acute water shortages.
During 2010-2011, there was a severe drought. The dam dropped still 18%. So they need water supply because there's a lot of houses. They built a lot of houses.
We are the third fastest growing town in the Western Cape and the seventh fastest growing town in the country. And with the tourists coming into peak season, then the influx is fourfold.
The municipality needed to secure its water future as it could not rely solely on surface water from local dams. Due to the effects of climate change, droughts may very well become more common in the future.
We called the community together and we had proper meetings with all the role players and people with expertise to find the right solutions to our problem.
Overstrand looked at various potential interventions, including reusing wastewater and desalination.
We looked at all the options and luckily we found a lot of groundwater below Hermanus, and that proved to be the most feasible option at the end, and we implemented it.
But there was a unique challenge. This water contained high amounts of iron and manganese. The conventional water treatment works at Preekstoel in Hermanus, Overstrand's largest town, would not be able to treat this type of water. For this reason, the municipality decided to build a special biological water treatment works, the first full-scale plant of its kind in South Africa. This new treatment plant was built alongside the existing treatment works, which meant that the impact on the environment was kept to a minimum. Instead of using chemicals, bacteria are used to treat the water.
You only create the right conditions for the bacteria in the sand filters in terms of pH and oxygen content, and then they do the job.
Another one of the big advantages of the plant is that it uses less energy than a conventional plant, as it requires less backwashing.
We save on electricity, we save on finances, and we save on manpower because the plant is running it at its own.
The water from the plant comes from 11 boreholes, 7 of which are newly developed. The Friedrich Naumann Foundation for Freedom contributed some grant funding towards research on the modeling of these boreholes.
We managed to secure a water use license from the groundwater supplies of 2,400 megaliters per year. So that's almost another De Bos dam.
This new development has helped to secure Overstrand Municipality's water future. Both Drakenstein and Overstrand are examples of municipalities that are making huge strides in good water management. With effective management, proper planning and innovation, local residents and businesses can benefit from secure water supplies at reasonable tariffs.
It is really amazing to have people that are so dedicated to their jobs, because that is something that is very peculiar nowadays in all spheres of life, and especially in local government.
I'm extremely proud of the engineering department, and specifically my water engineers, to be able to have the blue drop status and the green drop status that we've achieved this year once again.
Only through good governance can the rights to dignity, sufficient water, and an environment that is not harmful to one's health or well-being be realized. A reliable water supply is essential for economic development and a better life for the people of South Africa.